Good evening. The serial killer who murdered three women and terrorised Frankston has lost a bid for freedom. Family and friends of his victims say parole should never be available to Paul Denyer. Neri Tai has today's developments.
For a father who has endured so much pain, finally a win for Brian Russell.
Best news we've had for 30-odd years.
His daughter's murderer, Paul Denyer, will remain behind bars. After years left in the dark, Mr. Russell received a surprise phone call from the Department of Justice around 11 o'clock this morning.
Just such a relief too, because it's watching the things the parole board has done over the last few years.
It's been months of anguish for the loved ones of the women taken by serial killer Paul Denyer after the confessed murderer applied for parole last year.
We were getting to a point we thought, well, it's 50-50 that he might get parole.
Denyer randomly killed three young women in the span of just 6 weeks in 1993. 18-year-old Elizabeth Ann Marie Stevens and 22-year-old Seaford mum Debbie Freeham, her baby just 12 days old at the time. He was sentenced to life but won an appeal for a non-parole period of 30 years.
He hasn't changed. That's the way he's programmed. When we interviewed him, he said he had the urge to kill when he was 15. He'll always kill.
David Limbrick was Natalie Russell's boyfriend. Now an MP, he says he will speak to the government about legislation to stop Denyer continuing to apply for parole.
I think the current process and the way that it works has just been far too traumatic for everyone involved, and we just can't keep going through this every few years.
Today, the highly secretive Adult Parole Board wouldn't comment on the specific case, only shedding some light on the criteria, whether the prisoner has completed required treatment programs or whether they have behaved in custody.
Well, the lady I spoke to this morning told me that things would have to change drastically for him to be allowed to apply for parole again.
The 51-year-old has never given a reason for the killings or shown any remorse.
We know he's had 30 years to turn his life around if he wanted to do that, and he's done nothing.
Neri joins me now from Frankston. Neri, what's been the community's reaction?
Well, Pete, these three murders really rocked the Frankston community in the 1990s, and it's safe to say that residents here would be breathing a sigh of relief tonight, especially the families of those three murdered women. When I spoke to Brian earlier this afternoon, he was so overwhelmed by today's news and happy, but he says there's still work that needs to be done because Paul Denyer can still apply for parole in the future. So the families are really calling on the state government to introduce some sort of legislation so that this serial killer will remain behind bars for life, Pete.
Neri Tai reporting. Thank you, Neri.